Welcome to my channel. It's been a long time I haven't made any video. Since my little girl is growing and she needs my complete attention. Say hi. Hi. Hi.
Hi.
So I couldn't get much time to make videos, but I still don't want to disappoint my subscribers who are my strength to run my channel. So I have come up with a few ideas to make some videos. Here is my request. Please watch these videos and share. Thank you so much. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this hanging shelves, or we can call it as wall drop hanging shelves or cloth organizer. So this is made out of cloth. So you can see here there are four shelves, partitions, so we can use for a multi-purpose. So wait no longer, let's start the process. Here I have taken a cotton fabric which is little bit thick, and you can take whichever the material you wanted. So I have taken 13 inches of the width and 45 inches of the length. So this length will be the height. So it will be 13 into 45 inches. With the same measurements, I have taken one more piece for the other side. So these two pieces will be the sides. So for them, I have taken lining also to make it little stiff for both the pieces. I'm going to cut little cross on the top side. Why? Because so this should stand on the wall side. So that's why I cut. So I have taken 5 inches. So I marked 5 inches and made a line and then cutting. Now this will be back side and this will be front side. So I'm just going to cut stitch in the front side. So we have finished stitching front side, you can see. So the front side is stitched. So we just left back side like that only. Now we are going to take partition. So I have taken a little thicker board, so with the 11.5 inch. So it will be like this. We need to because it's 13 inches, right? So half inch has gone for stitching and half inch we are leaving, and both the sides, so it will be 11 inches. Now we are going to close this with the cloth. So here I have taken a silk material which I am already having at home. So we are going to make one stitch here. So I have done stitching it. So now this measurement will be 12 inches and 9 inches. So we left little place for the stitches, so it will be 9 inches. And for the top one, we are going to make little difference. So because we need to put the handle, so I have taken 6 inches and then I am going to make a stitch both the sides. So you can see I have finished stitching. Now we are going to attach this here. So to attach properly, equally, so I'm just going to draw two lines. So I'm going to stitch on those lines. So I'm done with the attaching this handle. Now I'm going to take the pad and just make a stitch. So here we're going to stitch. So I have done stitching it, you can see now it's very stiff. So like that I have made 5, so that I can make 4 partitions.
So to make the four partitions, first I am just marking because we need to get equal side. So once I mark like that, so I'm going to measure the distance between all these marks. So it will be 9.5 inch. See, 9.5 inch, here also 9.5 inch. So I'm going to make a lines so that when I'm stitching, it will be easy for me to stitch. I have marked for both, you can see. Now, so take the sheet and the cloth side should be the front side. So I'm just going to make a place like this and make a stitch. So you can see like this and make a stitch. Like that, place all of them and make a stitch. We are done with one side, so I'm going to do the other side also. So the top one I'm going to make first, so place like this and stitch, then one by one. We have done attaching both the sides. You can see we have got the partitions 1, 2, 3, 4, and so we got four partitions, and now we're going to attach back side. So we are going to close back side. We are going to take one more piece of cloth to attach this with the same measurements. So I have taken the material and this is 11 inch width I have taken with the same length. So for the front, the top side should be little thick to hang on the wall. So I'm going to make it little thick with these two linings. So just make a stitch like this. I have done stitching, so I'm just going to turn this side and make one more stitch strongly. We are done. Now I'm going to place this material back side and make a stitch. So just like this, I'm going to fold this little extra material because it was only 9 1/2. I have taken 11 inches for extra folding. Just fold like that and make a stitch. We have finished attaching back side. You can see clearly here. So we finished attaching. And now you can see we have 4 shelves. And this one to be hung in the shelves to the pipe. And now to hang on the wall, we need to make 2 holes. So I'm using these to close the holes properly. Finish fixing those buttons. You can see even back side. So we are done with the fixing buttons. Now let's see how can we use this. So I want to fix this in the wardrobe. This is my wardrobe I use for my daughter. So I want to fix this here. You can use both the ways. The left side I have hanged it on the wall. The right side I have hanged it in the cupboard.